Let's start. Good evening, one and all. Welcome to this workshop, 4-day workshop of small office, home office, going digital. This workshop today will be focused on basic functions about marketing. What are the aspects that a small office or a home office has to look when they plan to go digital, and what are the things they have to take care of? The way this session is organized is like we'll be sharing some insights about marketing and our experience of working with the customers and few things about it. And then we will try to, second part, we will try to show the demo of some sample apps that can be done with a solution that we are working on, which is called no-code solution or no-code platform. And this is Mani Lakaraju, founder of SolveWorks. And we are helping founders or entrepreneurs to translate these ideas into startups. And in this process, we help entrepreneurs with three basic support: one on mentoring, second on technology advisory, and third on helping them raise the funds. So this workshop is purely experience for founders or the entrepreneurs to understand technology and enable themselves in going digital. And in this, we will be showcasing all the demos of applications done on no-code platform. Let's start. Okay, today is the fourth day. On Monday, we have completed the sales flow, and we have seen the insights, and we have seen how quickly and smartly we can build some apps. On Tuesday, we have checked and got into the product side, how we can exclusively show the products on an online platform, and how we can take the content to be taken care. Next, we have looked at teams, how can we manage teams, understanding both these changes on the online platform or going digital, and also help them with all the needed tools and make them resourceful so that they can deliver jobs on time. And today we'll be looking at marketing flows at a very high level. As I shared in the previous sessions, this insights or whatever we are sharing is based on a 20,000 feet level of your actual line of business. This is a high level summary of how things are done while considering app making for marketing. So this is the guideline or disclaimer I would like to put, and you can take these insights and try to look at how you can make it better for your business line or for your business, for actual business on the field, and we can help you with the relevant solutions that can support going further. Great. So let me start. Okay, now what I'll be doing is I'll be asking everyone to unmute, and I'll be sharing some kind of topics. So we'll just try to connect with the topic and try to see, and then we'll go with the insights. Okay. Now the flow is like this. I will be talking about few aspects of marketing and few concepts of marketing, basically trying to connect the holistic picture of marketing and try to introduce what is required for startup founders and all. And we'll be sharing demos on these typical kind of apps, which will help companies understand how to create this kind of marketing hives or a directory or content management, how to do. There are various ways of handling content management. So we'll try to demonstrate all this. And finally, we'll try to also share something called as a marketer kit. What could be a kind of a typical marketing mode that you have to take with the surveys and all that kind of stuff we'll try to show. Right? So, and I would like to start the session with a positive quote, or with a quote which I like all the time: the best marketing doesn't feel like marketing. So when you actually do marketing, you should not get that hype that something has been created. That is a very expected function of a product. When it goes into the market, the awareness has to be spread. So the simplest way you do it becomes the best. So let's start the session with this kind of a quote. Now, what I'll be asking is, I'll be asking participants to unmute themselves and just participate for one or two slides, so that you all come to know what exactly is the insights of this session going to be. Okay. Please, can you unmute? So just be with it. So this is a typical approach. On the left, what we see is what we think we are doing for marketing. Assuming the yellow circle is a market and orange circle is our company, we build a lot of marketing and try to push into the market. So this is all what we see. But in reality, how it is on the right side. The same market space is taken by competitor one and competitor two. So whenever you try to do a similar kind of activity, so it is easy that the competitors can actually capture. And so that's why whatever we are trying to create in the marketing field and trying to take it to the advertisement or spreading the awareness, we have to be very clear and we have to make it very crisp so that it is very unique and it is connected to our products. It should not be generic and it should not be taken or mapped or wrongly understood for our competitor. So what I would like to bring to everyone's notice is good content isn't about a good storytelling. It is about telling a story, a true story. Well, just tell the true story in the right sense that is connected to your product, your features, your company, making it very, very interesting and very unique. Don't try to create content more in line of a race or in line of a similarity with what your competitors do, because you are going to work in the same market. When we do a creative, we think it is totally different and it is going to go to some other market. But the reality is we are going to be sharing the awareness or whatever in the same market with all our competitors. So always try to tell a true story and tell it well. Just make it simple and crisp and try to deliver the true story. Then only it works in real sense of marketing. Now this slide, how does this slide look to everyone? I want to hear some comments. Anything you would see, please share. It looks cluttered, whatever comes to your mind, you can share. So, or let me facilitate with some questions.
Mari, for me, it's like I'm teaching my 2-year-old daughter about the shapes. That's how I read this. Man.
Yeah. Got it. Any other comments? Any other pointers?
Well, not only is it cluttered, but it is also, overlapping each other.
Okay.
I see some symmetry.
Okay.
For me, it looks like too many things are put in a haphazard way.
Okay. Great.
There is no date which it has been kept.
Right. So, from looking at this slide, we heard so many versions of the understanding from the image. Assume this is the content and this is what your products and features and services are showing. So this is how your consumers or your customers is going to receive, right? So the point I'm trying to highlight here is engagement is not the choice. It's just a chance. So make it right. So in this example or in this exercise, little exercise, what we have done, we are trying to sell some kind of product or service or trying to make aware, but there are various kind of pointers that have come to it. So it's like various people engage themselves with different choices, but I am looking for just a chance to make a sale, right? So the point I'm trying to highlight here is engagement is the only option in a digital space for the customers to connect with the marketing or all the activities of marketing. So don't make it clutter, don't make it overlap, don't make it, try to connect with your exact product and services to your target customers in the exact way. That's what I want to bring. There is engagement happened here today also in all these various comments, but it is not for the target market. So you have to create your content exactly, because you lose the engagement, you lose the chance, you lose the customer. So you have to be very careful. This is one thing. Now, next slide also I would like to bring. What do you see from this slide?
Things are a little organized, but not yet labeled.
Right. So here, what we have learned is from the previous slide, if it is too much of detail, too much of things that we are trying to do, various people consume the information in the market in their own ways. Now, when we have also organized it, still it is not trying to connect to the right audience. So the only way you have to be is you have to present your content closest in a creative fashion to your target customers. And the only way is you have to clear the clutter and try to be more creative. So depending on whichever is the best creative form that a founder or an entrepreneur can take to present the content which signifies the product and services, we have to work in that way. And the beauty is when we have organized, at least we were able to connect to some kind of an information. So try to keep your content as less as possible, as clear as possible, as distinctive as possible, as you see in the picture with a lot of colors. Every color is distinctive of each of the one. And also, there is good amount of spacing, good amount of readability, good amount of connectability. All these things happen when you have a clear content and it is creative. So these are just two options of being creative. There is nothing high about it, but it is better than the previous slide. This is highly better than this one. So this is where you have to create an engagement. You have to take the chance only by making it creative. And that is what 80% of customers would like to connect with you on online marketing and purely on this kind of online platform when you take your marketing function to online and making it digital. Now, what to do? So what is that a founder or an entrepreneur has to do when he takes this kind of function to digital? See, definitely there are certain aspects that one has to understand. The first one is develop a marketing strategy. See, most of the times we are in rush to make a post or make a like or share some pictures and try to get that attention. We might get that attention, but we will not get the customer. Our target customer will not look at us because they see only the clutter, which I've shared, and you lose the chance of engagement. And you have to be very creative. Once these two things are not done, it will not happen. And typically, what should a strategy should include? That is another important question. It should start in this following order, which I mentioned here. It should always start with a word of mouth marketing, which is called WOM. Word of mouth marketing is a very essential way you would connect. Though you are doing on a social media or whatever, try to use a word of mouth marketing as a strategy to spread the initial word about your product or your features. Then try to take the next level as a SMS as a channel, because 80% of your customers sometimes can be on an analog phone or a different phone receiving the message or receiving the connect point. So that is also very important. And then the next one in the order is email marketing. So you try to devise your marketing campaigns or whatever to continuously connect your customers by telling stories through email marketing. And it has been proved in the past that 80% of email marketing campaigns are successful, because they sell a story and they sell that engagement continuously. They keep the audience connected with your story. So email marketing to a great extent works, but don't spam. The idea is not to spam. The idea is to take a story and try to connect to the customer, personalize the message and try to share with him. Don't spam. Spamming is also another big issue, which we have learned using chimp mail and a lot of things, where we just take a subscription and they give 100 mails or 1,000 mails and we start spamming. Don't spam. looked for 10 or 15 kind of themes of the story, then try to build that storyline and try to ensure that your story is delivered. And 80% of these email marketing has been successful, and it's been very, very 100% success. I mean, 80% of the times it is successful when it has been delivered. The next one in the order is content marketing management. Content marketing is not only about sharing the relevant information. It can also be a video clip. It can also be a 2-minute video. It can also be a image. It can also be a kind of a survey. It can also be a kind of a session. It can also be a kind of a poll. Lot of ways you can engage the content. Don't try to assume content is always only bulk text or some text or some always some action items or some marketing flyer or some most used words, prime words to be put in your message. No, it's not that. It's more of trying to deliver the same content across various formats. It could be questionnaire, it could be poll, as I've shared, it could be across various formats. So the customer likes it as you spread across various formats and he starts consuming the content more and more. Then comes your social media marketing. So in a social media marketing, what is important nowadays is more you have to be the walk the talk person. Then only people will connect to you and you have to keep your brand alive. So if you're trying to just do some forward, just try to do some post and just try to say something, the sell will not happen. It will just drop. People also doesn't turn back on your post. What you have to do is you have to definitely the storyline for all of this is the same, is a standard. But here you have to basically try to give out your success stories, try to give out how you have come out with the kind of differences that you have done. Connect your heart and try to spread the message. So that kind of connection has to establish on a social media. Then only it will create a value addition, or else it will only take you to a more post and it will not create that kind of attention span. Second, after social media is your affiliate marketing. So you can have influencers. There are a lot of ways you can get influencers. Influencers are there on social media, influencers are there on WhatsApp, influencers are there on TikTok, influencers are there on Facebook. So you should decide who are your influencers, because affiliate marketing also plays a bigger role. I was actually surprised with the recent count. Most of the consumer segment products are reached or accepted mainly through TikTok videos. And that's a really astonishing result. And most of the people connect to these videos, small videos, and they buy the product. So that's how affiliate marketing can also be very stronger. It can be of a bigger impact. Then comes officially your SEO, search engine optimization. But the days of search engine optimization is more an administrative job now. Once you attain a stage, once you attain a volume of your business activity and you're clear to step into a next level, then you try to look at SEO. Those days are gone. When you do a SEO, you might be still in the market, but the conversion rate is not that great, which I've looked at, knowing a lot of startups or a lot of MSMEs which are doing the early stage SEO when they launch the product. Every SEO cycle has 6 months minimum to contain that kind of potential. So until you can start the SEO with a small budget, defined budget, let the SEO keep building on its own. And then parallelly, you do all the orders like WOM, SMS, EMM, CMM, SMM, AFM, and then it will add value to SEO. And then next is online advertisement marketing. There are a lot of sites where you can actually choose yourself to be part of the online advertisement, but most of the niche products or most of the focused products see that as a noise, because the idea is not to make money, but it still sometimes felt as a noise. So depending on your level of reach and level of advertisement, you can choose this online advertisement paid marketing either on YouTube or Facebook or anywhere else. And finally, the normal advertisement you can go to. I mean, once you are grown up and you have that kind of attention, or you want to target to grow to that attention, then that's when you can go with advertisement, or you want to do a big bang launch, or you want to capture the market in a different way of viewership, readership. Then you have the money as well. Then you can directly choose advertisement. That's anyhow a known thing. That's really not a topic of discussion. I just want to just summarize these things so that what has to be part of your strategy. So developing a marketing strategy means how much I have time I have to spend on warm, how much time I have to spend on SMS, how much time I have to spend on email marketing, how much time I have to create the content and spend time on content marketing, how much time I have to spend on social media marketing. So all these things are to be listed and made a plan, and then that becomes a strategy. And for everything, try to put some measure. Like the best measure is, what is the cost of acquisition of your customer to all these channels, and what is the rate of conversion? If you can get these two measures across the channels, then I think your strategy is good, and you will get various parts of the strategy working for you to make the bigger picture. And the next one is, when you do all these things, eventually you're creating a strong brand. And these days, brand is more looked at as live. Unless until brand is a living thing, people don't get connected. So that's what you see most of the bigger companies try to create the brand live. Like, let's say Nike or Reebok, they use the sprinters or they use the pace runners to ensure the brand is connected to the live activity, what these people do. Similarly, you have to build an active page. You have to make it very ready, very much ready, where you can actually reach out to people. And it's easy for people to also try to stop by and look at. And as I said yesterday, the average time or a window of engagement for online is hardly 8 to 20 seconds. So your page, website, or whatever it is, you have to get the connection or engagement with them in 8 to 20 seconds. So that is the range that can help you good results. And also get found on online. So that is another activity. When you start doing the social media marketing, when you start doing your content marketing, when you start doing your email marketing, automatically you will be found by people on social media or online, and they will try to reach. That is one more important aspect you have to do as part of your marketing process when you go online. So design your applications, design all your connectivities where people can be found online. Like, let's say someone lands on your website, you should always give an option. Can you get a quote and things like that, or a chat bot? Now the bots are taking over. That's a different story. I'm not discussing all that here, but I'm just trying to connect all the basic things that a founder can do when they can go digital. Similarly, boost your online presence. You can do that by using the chat bots on your website or diverting traffic. There are various mechanisms where you can do that. That brings the online visibility. Then stay connected. As I said, email marketing is the best tool that can tell stories. But you have to make your entire storyline for the product and try to reach out to your customers only to let them understand what is your story all about. And it has to be true, and it has to be simple and clear. Let's not try to create something different and try to make it more artificial. And finally, if you could try all of them and collect it with a little kind of print, like a brochure or a kind of some goodies that can be connected more on the direction of corporate gifting or whatever, that can also be looked at. And this completely makes a package for founders to work on all these things as part of the strategy when they go online and when they go digital. So this is the few of the fundamentals that we have to look at as founders when we go digital on the marketing side. I have just one slide, then I'll take a break, look for questions, and then we'll go for demo. Okay, so in a nutshell, what is that we have to do? The strategy, these all things are good, but let's try to get into more of an action driven now. What is that we have to do? We have to create something called as knowledge center for people to come, the customers to come, browse, understand, spend some time and all. We should also have a facility of user directory where people can use or your entire company, your vendors, your colleagues, everyone, your customers can also try to reach out to the directory. It should be open and they should be able to connect so that it makes more transparent for them. But again, this can be personalized. It cannot be like let's say you are being target to some kind of unwanted calls. You can still personalize that and try to only take the calls that you are intended to receive. Then you have to focus on bulk email or that email marketing. That is one very important aspect that we have to look at. I have used the word bulk here is like we have to reach all our customers. Either we are going to prospective or served or to be served customers, all of them, the kind of story has to be connected to all of them. That's the reason I have to use bulk here. Then you have to keep continuously conducting a lot of polls. Very simple questions, very simple things that you can ask and the customers can come back to you with a yes or no. And that can help you take your connect back into your sales and try to nurture that. Similarly, surveys are of a great deal. You can do video surveys, you can do image-based surveys, you can do text-based surveys. I'll be showing little kind of things of all of that. We'll take a look of surveys, we'll take a look of emails, we'll take a look of all these things when we do the demo. And then also when you conduct an event, try to take that online by creating a simple interface which can actually make it available. Those are the days initially when we used to have a dedicated desk making people register, all those things, but those things are already now taking shape. The transformation is already happening. So whenever you plan to do an event, make it online, use QR codes, use all these kind of payment gateways, try to settle it off earlier and just do the event in the time. Don't create any confusion at the time of event. So we also show a quick app, how you can manage this kind of events for your company and how can you get from it. And finally, I'll try to throw some light on content gallery, how it can be done. Okay. Let's start the demo. Any questions until now?